What's up, budget builders? My name is Trill, and I am glad to be back again with you guys, sharing some of the latest news regarding the infrastructure packages, which includes the $1.2 trillion bipartisan bill and the currently priced $3.5 trillion budget reconciliation bill, which we will probably see that price tag being cut down in the near future if the Democrats want to pass that bill without having to deal with any more issues. Again, I was on a little vacation, so I apologize for being gone so long, guys, but it's great to be back again. And I have some great news to report today. The House just passed the bill late last night for the debt ceiling hike. This bill was really starting to make a lot of us nervous as we were on the verge of our country being shut down and running out of money if Congress didn't get their act together either to increase the debt ceiling or to either extend it for a little bit longer. Well, they were able to do just that over the course of the last 6 days. So now they have temporarily kicked the can down the road just a little bit to get over this hurdle just for now. The passing of this bill does allow them to suspend the debt ceiling until early December. But of course, they will have to do something again when that time comes. We also have some startling news in Texas, my home state, where the governor has issued another mandate against a different mandate. It's crazy, guys. And last but not least, we do have some positive news regarding COVID-19 that I want to share with you. The virus cases, infections appear to be slowing down again. But anyways, guys, hey, those are just some of the topics that we are going to cover today. Now, if this is your first time to the channel, hey, welcome and glad to have you. On this channel, we talk about finance, real estate, credit cards, Bitcoin and crypto, and stimulus update news. So if you're interested in any of those, go ahead and hit the subscribe button for me. That way you can join our community. Also, if you end up liking the content in this video or even laughing at one of my jokes, then be sure to like this video. Other than that, guys, hey, let's go ahead and jump right into the video. Okay, guys. 45 states are doing much better now with COVID-19, but they're still having issues in 5 specific states. Cases of COVID-19 are declining across the country, with 90% of states seeing numbers either sustained or either going down over the past week. However, the remaining 10% or 5 states have seen an increase in COVID-19. Montana, Colorado, Minnesota, Michigan, and Pennsylvania are still surging hotspots, while the rate of infection is dropping nationally, according to a CNN report. Now, this is some good news, and hopefully is going to continue to go in that trajectory downward, according to Anthony Fauci. Said, we have just been careful that we don't prematurely declare victory in many respects. We still have around 68 million people who are eligible to be vaccinated that have yet been vaccinated. If you look at the history of surges and diminutions in the cases over a period of time, they can bounce back again. In some of these states, patients are overwhelming emergency rooms. In Michigan, Rob Davidson of Spectrum Health Gerber Memorial told CNN that during his shift, he had 6-7 people sitting in the emergency department waiting for beds at other hospitals that didn't exist. A few months ago, Colorado had a rate of new coronavirus infections that was lower than the national rate. Rachel Hurley, the state epidemiologist, told the Denver Post, while new infections are falling across most age groups, cases are spiking among children being between the ages of 12 and 17 years old, the Denver Post reported. The statewide positivity rate, or the number of COVID-19 tests that come back positive, has risen in recent days in Colorado, a 7.22% increase to be exact. In Pennsylvania, there was recorded 3,500 new cases last Saturday, according to the State Department of Health. This brings the total of cases in the state to about 1.49 million people. As of now, the state has recorded more than 29,000 deaths, according to a weekly report. Although Montana has the fewest new cases of deaths, there have been an increase last Friday, a reported of 1,300 new cases, according to the state health department. The death toll to 2,079 people, with only 9 people dying since Saturday. As Changing America previously reported, one of the worst places in the U.S. to have COVID-19 last week was Alaska, as the state struggles with a high caseload and limited health care resources. But we do have some good news right here, is that Merck requesting U.S. authorization for the first COVID-19 pill. Merck & Company Incorporated said on Monday that it has applied for the U.S. emergency use authorization for its drug to treat mild to moderate patients of COVID-19, putting it on course to become the first oral antiviral medication for the disease. An authorization from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration could help change clinical management of COVID-19, as the pill can be taken at home. Now, this, guys, is breaking news, because right now we only have a treatment from a vaccine that you have to get an actual shot in your arm, and you have to actually get that vaccination 2 times over a 4-week period. So this Merck pill being introduced to the public can be a game changer, because people can just order it over the counter and take it at home at their leisure. They are saying that this treatment could cut the rate of hospitalizations and death by 50% in a trial of mild to moderate ill patients who had or at least one risk factor from the disease. The drug maker has a U.S. government contract to supply 1.7 million courses at a price of $700 per course. Merck expects to produce 10 million courses of the treatment by the end of 2021. It has also agreed to license the drug to several India-based generic drug makers, which are expected to supply the treatment to more than 100 low- and middle-income countries. So again, guys, this, as being simple as taking a pill at home, is going to be a game changer as far as fighting COVID-19 in this country, as well as other countries. Being able to take this pill at home instead of having to make an appointment with your doctor, or setting up an appointment to go to CVS or either Walgreens, just sitting at home and taking this pill. But again, just being able to take this pill at home and being able to have an effective rate of 50% or more, protecting patients from either the effects of having COVID or even preventing you from getting COVID, this is going to be a game changer, guys. I'm really excited about this. In other news, we are dealing with a lot of shortages right now on goods and services. Right now, they are stating that there are a ton of ships sitting at sea that are holding tons of goods that are helping out our global supply chain, which is being disrupted. We heard from Jen Psaki of the White House press secretary, and she said that President Biden is planning on meeting sometime today on Wednesday and meeting with the executives of Walmart, Home Depot, and UPS to discuss the supply demands and the disruptions at the ports. President Biden is planning to host a meeting Wednesday on supply chains, as disruptions have led to a lower world growth forecast and threatened to snarl the holiday shopping season. Biden said that the White House will meet with senior officials and stakeholders to discuss the collective efforts to address the global transportation supply chain bottlenecks, as well as the delivery remarks afterwards. So again, guys, this is definitely necessary, because we need to figure out what we can do to help out with these ports. Because right now we just have these large shipping boats and cartons sitting at bay right now. We've got to figure out a way to get these things on bay, unload them, and be able to get those shipping trucks to get those loaded on, to ship these things to the stores where necessary, so that we can get those to the consumers who need them the most. And that goes for the actual goods, it goes for our foods, it goes for services, it goes for, we need people to figure out how we can hire more people, because right now there are so many jobs available right now and nobody is taking these jobs. So we have to figure out a way to fix these issues. Other than that, we just gonna have these large containers sitting with these goods and no one to ship them to the stores that needs them the most, to ship them to the consumers. Okay, guys, good news. Yesterday, late last night, the House passed a short-term debt limit hike, pushing high stakes deadline to December. Late last night, the House passed a short-term increase in the debt ceiling to enable the Treasury to continue to borrow money to pay the bills for two more months, setting up another round of fighting about the limit. The House voted 219-206 on a partisan lines. President Joe Biden is expected to sign the bill, which moved forward Thursday after narrowly clearing a 60-vote threshold and passing in the Senate last Thursday. This measure, the product of a last-minute deal struck in the Senate, offers only a temporary reprieve and is likely to set up another round of fighting in December. It sets a new deadline of December the 3rd to hit the debt ceiling again. Senators and aides said last week that the Treasury would most likely have some wiggle room beyond that to continue meeting obligations. It would also set up another battle in December when the new deadline lapsed. Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell struggled to get Republicans' votes to approve of the short-term deal after backing off his opposition in the final stages. McConnell sent a letter Friday telling President Biden that he will not be a party to any further effort to resolve the debt ceiling problem, insisting that Democrats use the more centrist budget process, which Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer and numerous other Democratic senators have ruled out. McConnell got rare criticism from Senate GOP colleagues for what they called a capitulation to Democrats, with some saying that he blinked to save the filibuster rule as he sought to relieve pressure on pivotal centrist senators to use the so-called nuclear option to change the rules. And then we heard from former President Donald Trump, the de facto leader of the party, who appears to be building a campaign for the White House again, also piled on dubbing him Folding Mitch McConnell for agreeing to debt limit increase without concessions. Increasing the debt limit does not authorize new spending. It enables the government to pay bills that Congress has racked up over the leadership of both parties over many years. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi told reporters Tuesday there would be devastating economic consequences if the borrowing limit were to be breached. She gave a boost to legislation by Representative Brendan Boyle and Representative John Yarmuth that would end the debt ceiling as it currently exists by transferring the authority to raise it to the Treasury Secretary rather than requiring a vote of Congress. I think it has merit, Pelosi said, adding that Congress would be able to vote to overrule such a move. So yeah, guys, this is some very great news as Congress, both the Senate on Thursday as well as the House on Tuesday, have passed the bill to temporarily extend this ceiling debt limit all the way through December the 3rd. So now they can continue to pay their bills. And this is some also good news because that means that they will be sending out those stimulus checks that are coming later this week on the 15th, which is the child tax credit. Before, there were some issues regarding whether those were going to be being sent out if Congress didn't pass this bill, because the government was going to either shut down as well as they were going to be unable to pay their bills as well as their other obligations. But they have just passed this bill, and now we are just waiting on President Biden to sign this bill sometime this week. And then we can assure that those child tax credit checks or those stimulus checks will be sent out to, I believe, 90 million families. This is huge, guys. Now we just have to wait and see what the Democrats are going to be able to do from now through December the 3rd. Hopefully, they do something in the earlier term versus waiting to the end closer to December, because we cannot go through this again, guys. They need to figure out how they're going to pass this and then whether the Republicans are going to be able to help them with passing this debt ceiling to increase the amount, because right now they are just suspending this temporarily, but they do need to increase the amount before December the 3rd. What do you guys think about this? Do you guys think this is some exciting news? And then also, according to Nancy Pelosi, do you think that they should take this vote away from Congress and go ahead and give it to the Treasury Secretary so that we don't have to worry about this bottleneck being inside of Congress, you know, fighting with the Republicans and the Democrats? If we can just go ahead and pass this over to whomever the Treasury Secretary is at that time during that specific presidency, then we can avoid having this particular government shutdown, and we can go ahead and increase the debt limit when the time is needed. Let me know what you guys think about that down below in the comment section. And last but not least, guys, here in Texas, Governor Greg Abbott bans vaccine mandates from any entity in Texas. Now, this is a little bit strange because this is going against the mandate that President Joe Biden put down back in September, where he mandated that companies who have more than 100 employees are mandated to get the vaccine. Well, Governor Abbott is now banning that mandate from the president, which is very weird, guys. Governor Greg Abbott signed an executive order on Monday that bans coronavirus vaccine mandates from being implemented by any entity in Texas, the latest move in the state's crusade against the requirements amid the ongoing pandemic. Abbott's order says that groups of businesses in Texas are not permitted to require proof of vaccinations from individuals who object to the shots for any reason of personal conscience. This comes in a response to President Biden's mandate announced last month that all businesses with 100 or more employees require their workforces to get vaccinated or regularly tested. Greg Abbott said that no entity in Texas can compel receipt of a COVID-19 vaccine by any individual, including an employee or a consumer who objects to such vaccination for any reason of personal conscience based on a religious belief or for medical reasons, including prior recovery from COVID-19. It further states that violators of the order should be subject to maximum fine permitted under a section of the Texas government code. He said that the executive order will be revoked once a similar bill is passed. The COVID-19 vaccine is safe, effective, and our best defense against the virus, but should remain voluntary and never forced, the governor said in a statement. But hey, anyways, guys, hey, my time is up for today. This has been your fourth stimulus check update. Now, if you enjoy any of this information or found it to be useful, be sure to hit the like button for us. It definitely helps out a lot, and it also tells YouTube to share this video with others. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button for me so that you can be a part of this community, and hit the notification bell to be notified of each new video. Again, as always, hey, I appreciate you guys stopping by and watching, and I hope to see you on the next video. Peace.